This year at New York Toy Fair, the buzz is, of course, all about the hot toys, which I'll be getting into later in the show. But the industry is also talking about the potential of a comeback from global toy retailer Toys R Us. You might remember they went bankrupt last year, closing all of their U.S. stores by the end of June. Now, this is a big deal for the industry because so many toy makers relied on Toys R Us for a good chunk of their sales. Here's a look at the impact. When Toys R Us closed its American stores, more than 700 of them in June, tens of thousands of U.S. workers lost their jobs. Toy makers also lost a major distributor. The retailer accounted for up to 20% of all U.S. toy sales.
There may be a couple of very, very old people here who may remember a time before Toys R Us, but this has been part of the fabric of the toy industry, probably for everybody on the floor. So it's a big deal.
The bankruptcy led to the liquidation of the retailer's large inventory of toys, sold at rock-bottom prices that undercut competitors. Mattel and Hasbro, two of the world's largest toy makers, blamed the closure of Toys R Us for negative lingering effects on their latest earnings. But toy experts say the biggest impact has been on smaller startups, hoping to become the next big thing in the toy industry.
You know, Toys R Us had a lot of space for a lot of toys, and they would take some chances on some new companies, some new products, where some other mass market stores or even specialty stores might be a little hesitant to try something new.
Some have benefited from Toys R Us's closure. Target and Walmart have both beefed up their toy offerings. And over the Christmas holiday, Amazon mailed out a toy catalog for the first time ever. But Gottlieb says nothing compares to a store totally dedicated to toys.
No offense to Walmart or Target, but going to Walmart or Target is not a magical experience. It's a functional experience. I'm going there, best price, find the product I need. Going to a toy store should be a magical experience.
The hedge funds that own the debt and the intellectual property of Toys R Us want the retailer to make a comeback. Currently, they still have about 800 stores outside of the U.S. Former company executives have created a new entity called True Kids. Now, True Kids estimates around half the Toys R Us market is still available. To seize it, True Kids plans to open around 70 stores in Europe and Asia. Together, they hope to bring the brand back, but details are scant and the industry remains skeptical. Now, according to NPD Group, LOL Surprise was the best-selling toy brand of the year in 2018. It was also this year's winner of the Toy of the Year Award at New York Toy Fair. Unwrapping a collectible is still a hot trend now in 2019. And to get a sense for what else is trending this year, I caught up with toy expert Jennifer Gibbons at the Toy Association, who broke it down for us. The Toy Association has identified six main toy trends for 2019. One of the biggest, unboxing, where opening the toy is as exciting as the toy itself.
It's, you know, where kids either are searching for a rare collectible, or it's just a surprise of finding out what's inside once they open it. So that's going to continue to be a trend, but with new features that are going to take it to the next level in 2019.
One example is Zuru's Five Surprise mini brands. It looks like a ball that then turns into what looks like an orange. In each segment, there's a small toy. To the chagrin of many parents, the slime craze continues, as does interest in other compounds. Yulu has something in that category called pop-up snots.
And it's amazing because it combines four of the things that kids love. So the satisfaction of popping bubble wrap, slime, the collectability, there's 60 characters to collect, and the hunt for the collectible, because there's only one character in every three bubbles.
Another hot trend is the food trend. So here we have Foodie Roos, a plush toy that looks, feels, and smells like real foods.
The Toy Association says the food trend reflects the priority millennial parents place on good health.
So this is Professor Maxwell's 40 Chef. It's effectively food science, so you're learning about the science behind food. You're going to learn about avocado toast and what's the difference between good fat and bad fat.
This toy fits into the inspirational and aspirational play category, another trend for 2019. It's where kids can learn about different professions through enhanced learning. The toy uses virtual reality and apps to assist kids as they learn to cook and bake things. Licensed toys and games related to well-known TV and film characters will also be big,
in a trend called explosive entertainment.
We've got this SpongeBob SquarePants Giggle Blaster. You want to take a shot?
Yes, I can.
SpongeBob SquarePants is celebrating his 20th anniversary this July. Batman is turning 80 and Barbie is turning 60. That brings us to the last trend for 2019, throwback toys. Those raised in the 80s will remember classic arcade games like Tetris and Pac-Man. Both are available in tiny versions that you can actually play. They can also double as keychains. This category seems geared more for the parents feeling nostalgic about their own childhoods, but there's nothing wrong with that.
Most of the toys you just saw in that segment will be coming out towards the end of the year, hoping to cash in on the critically important holiday shopping season. Karina Huber, CGTN, New York.